I'm Chris Parker, and I'm a director of Inspired Cycle Engineering. ICE are based in Falmouth in Cornwall. We manufacture recumbent tricycles. We started back in late 90s, I suppose. I started working for a guy who'd who was building recumbent trikes at the time. They were then called the Trike, and I wanted a job and he wanted to retire, so I bought him out using my business partner Neil's money, and we went into business together manufacturing the trikes. Recumbent trike is a three-wheeled cycle, pedal cycle, that you sit in with a backrest and a little base, nice, basically a hammock seat, and you sit there with your feet in front of you in a very relaxed position, very comfortable. Basically they're go-karts for adults, but they're very serious pieces of kit that that you can ride all over the world on. They are expedition tough, and very comfortable and a lot of fun. Well, the polar cycle here was a project that we started in the summer of last year, 2013, and we were approached to build a trike for an expedition that we're trying to cycle from the edge of the Antarctic to the pole. Many people have tried to cycle in the Antarctic, but nobody had ever managed to cycle the whole way. People had taken bikes, but basically found that they were unrideable. The headwinds are too strong, the climbs are too steep, the going is too soft in places. It's just too much like hard work. So we were approached to design and build a trike that could do it. Why a trike? Because of the inherent stability of trikes, their aerodynamics, the way they can cut through a headwind is really handy. So you've got the stability, load carrying, you can just pile them up with stuff. They don't wobble about at slow speeds. They just sit there and grind their way forwards. This was never going to be a race about speed. It was always going to be a battle of attrition, if you like. Can you just keep going? Can you build a machine that just will not stop whatever gets put in front of it? And so that's what we set about designing. Obviously, the fat bike tires, biggest tires you can get to sit on top of as much snow as possible, so you sink as little as possible. The biggest knobbles we could get on the back wheel for the extra traction. A massive rack to carry all the gear that was going to be needed. And strong, you know, this machine must not fail. People are putting their lives, the rider was putting their life on the line for this. So it had to be really strong and had to stay together. It had to do it in one go. Trying to repair a trike in not just sub-zero, but sort of minus 40 degrees Celsius kind of temperatures wasn't going to happen. It had to be tough and it had to make it in one go. Some of the big challenges we knew we were going to face with this trike was getting it up really steep ascents. The Leverett Glacier is a formidable climb. It was going to take days and days to climb this glacier. So gearing, low gearing was going to be essential. You're not just battling against the snow, but against a steep climb as well. So that's why we put, obviously, mountain bike gears, but then divided that by two, so the gears are half what you'd expect on a normal mountain bike. So gear speed, if you like, pedaling speed, 2.5 miles an hour to top speed of about 12. We also fitted Q-rings because they're really great when cadence drops off when you're pushing up a hill. That oval chain ring really aids. The pedals just keep in moving. Everything about this trike was about aimed towards keeping it moving, or just even no matter how slow, just keeping moving forwards. So December 2013 came around. The machine went out to Antarctica, and battle commenced, as it were. And it was a tense few days. All we could do was sit and watch as the GPS signals were sent out and put out on the internet. And every 3 hours, a new position was posted, and We just watched it like hawks as this little dot slowly moved across the map. And yeah, there were tense moments when things went, you know, progress was very slow, and then you'd be getting up to, oh wow, nearly 3-4 miles an hour flying along at the moment. Anyway, 10 days later, after the 10 days after the start, there the little dot was right on the South Pole, and we were really delighted. So 27th of December, the machine had made it in 10 days, 14 hours and a few minutes, and yeah, we were well made up. So it became the fastest human powered journey from the edge of the continent to the pole, and it was the first pedal cycle ever to ride every single inch of the way. So we were really made up.